So this is not our Eid. It is not Eid in Kashmir. It is not Eid in Jammu. It is not Eid. It cannot be because it is against the very ethos.
This, as I would want to reiterate again and again, this is not a celebration. Our narrative is not to celebrate. Our narrative was to observe because there can be no Eid in Kashmir. There can be no Eid for anybody who belongs to that state and understands what that state has been through. The only thing that we could celebrate was the strength, the hope and perseverance that people of Jammu Kashmir inherently have. And to let the people know out and about that even in times of distress, people of Jammu Kashmir do stand together and we are in solidarity with people who are, we call our own back home, and people who are here who might feel alone at the time, to observe the entire thing together. Eid is one of the biggest festivals for the dominant population of Muslims there, and is celebrated by not only the Muslim population but everybody residing there with out and out fervor. So I'm sure there are no markets there, there are no hugs there, there's no one to celebrate with. So we are also not celebrating here, but we do in a way mourn for not being able to talk to our family, mourn for the entire undemocratic and inhumane attitude that the government of India has shown towards the state that they most dearly love. Claim to love, rather.
Basically, we have all gathered here to let it out that we're not celebrating, we're just observing, we're just making it known in common memory and common history that there was a Eid that was celebrated without any news from loved ones, any news at all.
Things are very bleak. What we are hearing from the national media are mainly false reports. There are some reports coming out of alternate media which are definitely scary, and today, after I think 8-9 days, in the morning I was able to talk to a colleague who lives in a remote area. I won't mention the area, and we were able to speak because the tower from Chandigarh catches there, and he told me that even in those areas which have never seen militancy, things are not good. Army is everywhere, not letting people go out for very long. And what he also told me, that most of the videos which are coming out are being made by the army, and they are asking people who work for the army, because there are people who are employed with the army, they are asking them to say that we are happy and everything is fine here. So that is one version. There must be many other versions also.
जैसा कि हमें मालूम है कि कुछ हेल्पलाइन नंबर गवर्नमेंट की तरफ से दिए गए हैं, जिससे कॉल करके वो लोग अपने बाहर पढ़ रहे लोगों से बात कर सकते हैं, बच्चों से बात कर सकते हैं, पर उसमें भी इतनी मुश्किल से टर्न आती है, इतनी लंबी लंबी लाइनें हैं, और जब किसी की टर्न आती है तो एकदम मतलब बिल्कुल जो आर्मी वाला है या जो भी ऑफिसर है वो बिल्कुल साइड में खड़े होके सुनता है कि कहीं ये कुछ ऐसा ना कह दे कि जिससे ये प्रॉब्लम हो, एक्चुअल हालात के बारे में कुछ इन्फॉर्मेशन ना चली जाए बाहर. उनसे ये कहा जाता है कि आप यही बोलो कि यहाँ सब ठीक है, और इससे ज़्यादा कुछ बोलने की उनको परमिशन नहीं है.
I do not know the kind of siege that they are under, because whoever even goes from Delhi to back Kashmir, there is no news from there. There is no news. We do not know what conditions they are living in. We do not know if at all they could wish their next door neighbor. We do not know what are they feeling. They do not know how we are feeling. So we do not choose to be here at Jantar Mantar. Our Eid was supposed to be at home. Everybody was present here. Their Eid was supposed to be at home with their loved ones.
People have not been able to get back to their loved ones. People don't have no news from their loved ones, you know. And for Eid to be celebrated that way is specially desolate. It's specially desolate. It's specially sorrowful. It's specially, you know, it wrenches your heart.
Thank you.
So we are quite perturbed by what's happening, and it's a shame. It's an attack on the very federal structure of our country and diversity.
Even if the majority was for the decision, then it would have been very evident. You have literally locked down an entire valley with a population of more than 6-7 million, and you have took all means of communications from them. You're not letting media travel around. We're not just talking about Srinagar. Like, Kashmir Valley has 15 districts, and nobody knows what is happening on the other parts of in other districts.
While it concerns the people of Kashmir today, but I think nobody should be under any misconception that it's going to be restricted to Kashmir. In fact, it hasn't been. The last few years, we've seen how there've been continuous mob lynchings across the country, how there've been continuous mob lynchings of Dalits, of Muslims, and people from various marginalized communities have suffered for various reasons, right? Because of the policies of this government. So let's also be clear that today it's the people of Kashmir who, and the constitutional promise that was made to the people of Kashmir during the accession of Kashmir, has been violated so grossly and so blatantly. And if they can do this kind of a, I mean, if they can violate the constitution so blatantly today for Kashmir, they can do it for anybody else. They will do it for anybody else, right? And so let's be prepared. And I think this is why it's important that people from different movements, people from different marginalized communities, people working in different movements need to come together today. These are not individual struggles any longer. You know, these are struggles for the dignified lives of the people of India, you know.
My dear son, hold your emotions, be in peace, we love you. He said while he dropped knife. Tears rolled down in numb cheeks and in people, everything is not so fine. But if you murmur right now, that I promise peace in your veil, I will celebrate you forever.
Thank you.